The worst form of human trafficking, that's how the DSWD Secretary Rex Gachalian calls the alarming sale of babies online. Earlier this month, a mother was arrested for trying to sell her 8-day-old baby through Facebook. The DSWD says it has monitored and reported dozens of Facebook pages involved in the sale of infants. Secretary Gachalian is calling on Meta to take down all those pages and for government to be more aggressive in regulating social media sites.
They use ICT, the children are being traded, and then they're not following the process set forth by law for proper adoption. So trafficking, this is the worst type of human cruelty. It's trafficking, but it's happening blatantly in our social media pages. And what have we done so far? Minus the monitoring, we've been working with PNP and NBI to catch these culprits. But at the same time, we've been talking to Facebook. In fact, after this incident, Facebook brought down around 12 of these 40 or so pages.
Philippine toll regulators green light the toll hike for the North Luzon Expressway beginning June 4, that's next Tuesday. Motorists traveling anywhere within NLEX's open system or from Balintawak, Caloocan City to Marilao, Bulacan will pay at least 5 pesos more to use the expressway. Those traveling NLEX end-to-end will pay as much as 81 pesos more. This is the second tranche of a toll hike after regulators implemented a similar increase in June last year. Police have arrested a suspect in that fatal road rage incident in Makati. This was confirmed by the chief of the National Capital Region Police Office. The suspect shot dead a family driver on the Ayala-EDSA southbound tunnel. The passenger, the victim, said the fatal incident started out as a traffic altercation with a suspect who was driving a black Mercedes-Benz. The shooting caused massive congestion on EDSA Tuesday as police closed the Ayala southbound tunnel to process the crime scene. An operative of the PNP's Highway Patrol Group and a former soldier apprehended for serving as security escorts. Raya Kapulong reports.
A motorcycle rider was flagged down and arrested by the personnel of the PNP Highway Patrol Group along Jokno Avenue in Parañaque City this Monday. It was later discovered that he is also a member of the PNP Highway Patrol Group. His companion, a former soldier, was also arrested.
They were escorting a vehicle who happens to speed away. So nakuha sila ng ating team from RHPU NCR. Per investigation, he was assigned here 2 years ago. It's MCU, Motorcycle Unit of HPG NCR.
Itong sundalo, no, dati assigned siya with the Headquarters Philippine Army because Army Intelligence Regiment. And he was discharged on 11 August 2022. However, hindi siya nakapag-file ng kanyang formal retirement because meron siyang pending case.
The PNP is investigating the owner of the vehicle they were escorting.
The road was too busy at that time then, and it would be very risky po yung situation. So they just happened to apprehend the two illegal escorts.
The PNP also confirmed that the two are being paid in exchange for escorting a private vehicle.
They're doing this kasi nagmumoonlight sila.
The two have been charged with usurpation of authority. PNP Chief General Romel Francisco Marbil is disappointed that another member of the police force is involved in such moonlighting activities.
Only with high threat and medium threat coming from PSPG lang ang pwedeng magbigay ng security. But it is based on sa threat assessment that will be made by our Directorate for Intelligence.
Marbil had earlier warned police personnel that they would be dismissed from service if it is proven that they are providing unauthorized security.
Bawal po ang mga police na magkukumpo ng other jobs na maliban sa pagiging police sila.
On May 18, two PNP Special Action Force personnel were arrested for serving as bodyguards to a Chinese national after a fistfight in a village in Muntinlupa. Raya Kapulong, ABS-CBN News.
From the governor of Bohol studying his next legal move to fight off a suspension order over the construction of a controversial resort in the iconic Chocolate Hills. Annie Perez now joins us with details. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, that's right. Suspended Bohol Governor Aris Omentado in a press conference said that he is now looking for legal remedies after he was issued a preventive suspension of 6 months by the Office of the Ombudsman. The suspension is in relation to the ongoing investigation of the Captain's Peak Resort erected in the middle of the Chocolate Hills in Sagbayan Town. Chocolate Hills is a protected area and a declared national monument. Omentado said that he personally received the order yesterday morning, May 28, as officials from the Office of the Ombudsman flew in from Manila to serve it to him. He adds he is only collateral damage at this time. Aside from Omentado, 68 others were also suspended, included previous governors such as previous governor Art Yap, Rene Relampagos, and representatives of former Governor Edgar Chato. There were also mayors whose jurisdiction are in the Chocolate Hills that are also suspended, and it also included regional directors from the Departments of Agriculture, Science and Technology, Environment and Natural Resources, as well as the Philippine National Police. Omentado recalls that those individuals in the order also used to sit as members of the Protected Area Management Board of the province, or more known as PAMBI. Omentado said that he accepts the decision of the ombudsman because there is really an investigation at the Senate and the House, but he also sees it as an opportunity for some, as this issue was very publicized and, to his words, sensationalized. He and his legal team will review and consult what could be done to defer the preventive suspension. One of the moves that they're considering now is to file for a motion for reconsideration before the Office of the Ombudsman. He's also to meet with all those mentioned in the order to discuss their next legal move as a group. When asked if the suspension was unfair, Omentado believes so that it is. But despite the suspension of himself and 68 others, he assured the public that the province's operations will continue business as usual. On his behalf, Vice Governor Junicio Balite will now function as acting governor of Bohol. Meanwhile, senior board member Tita Baha will now sit as acting vice governor of the province of Bohol. And that's the latest here from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie. ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro slamming Vice President and Education Chief Sara Duterte for asking the Supreme Court to junk petitions against her secret funds. See, Castro and her colleagues at the Makabayan Bloc filed the petitions questioning the transfer of 125 million pesos to the Vice President's confidential funds in 2022. Duterte argues none of the petitions present an actual case. However, Castro insists the issue of Duterte's confidential funds is not just theoretical, as it robbed millions of pesos from public coffers. She also calls for accountability from the vice president.